am from a particular religious denomination. And so, but then when I thought about it, the same reason why I ended up writing these books was the reason I decided I needed to be on this panel. Because I needed, if we are having a platform on which people talk about faith and how it informs their writing, does rationalism itself not have a place there? Does not deconstructing religion have a place there? And that is why I ended up writing, and that's also why I'm here today. So you must forgive me in advance if you find me a little irreverent, but that is how I tend to be. And it's not without reason, because when I think of my childhood, I had very progressive parents, but I really couldn't say the same for my grandparents. And so I have been brought up in a household where I have been subjected to things that I would find very ridiculous. I have also seen how they would treat other people differently because religion, caste, all of these things come into play. And what really, really used to piss me off the most was when I would ask, why are things done this way? The most standard answer I would get is because that's the way it's said in the scriptures. Now, so why did I start writing what I wrote? Because I cannot bear a view of the world where the scriptures or any of these beliefs can actually be so segregationist, can actually be so misogynist, especially, or can be so oppressive in many ways. So, in a sense, fictionalizing one of the sacred myths. My novels are based on the Mahabharata, which, as I'm sure many of you know, is one of the myths of India. But more than mythology, it's actually a sacred text. And part of the Mahabharata is what is known as the Bhagavad Gita, which is like the standard when you talk about a Hindu religious text. Like if you go into a court of law and you swear to tell the truth, as a Hindu, you would swear on the Bhagavad Gita to tell the truth. So that is sort of, it would be the equivalent of the Bible or the Quran in that sense. And that's what I'm writing about. And I want to, I wouldn't say fictionalize, but I would say I've had to deconstruct the mythology because I cannot bear the idea of a Bhagavad Gita or even an entire Mahabharata where women are oppressed or where caste becomes a discriminating factor. Or everything goes in the name of religion. No, it cannot be that way, and that is not my religion. So, yeah, I guess I'm coming from a very, irreverent is the word I use, but let me just clarify, when I say irreverent, it's not that I am disrespectful, so I guess that's what it means, but no. It's not that I mean to disrespect faith. I cannot be convinced by anything scriptural. I cannot be convinced by anything that compromises humanity and human benevolence in the name of divinity. And I think that's the thread you will find running through my entire book, where I take gods and I make human beings out of them and tell their story. Hey, but that doesn't mean that they've got to do bad things all the time. Human beings can be good people. Human beings give us hope. Human beings give us progress. Human beings are the ones who bring about revolution, not gods at the snap of a finger. So by humanizing and trying to demystify what would otherwise be considered a very spiritually contextual text, I'm trying to find a deeper and more fundamental meaning in it rather than to say that I disregard it completely or that I disrespect it. And the other thing that sort of emerged this was how I got into the field. The other thing that emerged as I started doing a lot of research in order to write these books is that many, many of the ancient scriptures, and when I say ancient, I'm talking about 4,000, 5,000, even 10,000 years is what they've been estimated at, scriptures such as the Vedas, things that are typically held as religious texts actually have a very secular scientific meaning if you would care to interpret them that way or translate them that way. So a lot of what I think on is, it's not that I'm disregarding the existence of these texts or I'm disregarding the factual possibility that things happen, but I'm saying there's another way to look at this completely, and that way has nothing to do with a particular religion or a particular set of gods. It's got to do with people. And that's good. So, yeah.
Thank you very much.